Let's see if I did a good job, eh? Sounding pretty good so far. so we're almost there. I'm now just going to do quite a lot of hand sanding. And then I've got to make some wedges to go into here. I'll do those out of oak to give a nice little contrast. And I have sanded with the orbital sander just around the middle, just to just make it slightly smaller in the middle. It's nice and smooth. I probably will go over the edges though and do something funky on the bottom, I reckon. Need to tidy that up. But for now, a lot of hand sanding. Mallet. Yeah, I'm really chuffed with it. Proportions feel great. It's a nice weight. It's nice and square to the handle. Tidied up the end. It feels great. But I think I'm gonna do a little bit more sanding, a little bit more filing on these channels, and then give it another proper sand. And then this weekend I'm making up some beeswax oil. And gonna put the first coat on this. Not a bad view for a day's work as well. case, we're pretty much so done with the hand sanding. And I only have 120 grit sandpaper with me, which is okay. But I want to give this that baby bum smooth finish. A good way of doing that is getting two bits of 120 and just rubbing them together slightly. So just do a little bit, give it a little feel. This one feels pretty good. You can feel the back, feel the front. You feel how gritty the back is, and the front still got a bit of grit, but it's a bit smoother. But this would bring us down to like a 240. And then if I wanted to go any further, I would just rub these two together again, and it will bring you up to like a 800 grit. But this seems pretty good. You can see how dull that side is, and this is just starting to get a bit of a shine back. That's good. So when I'm doing the final sanding, I'm always making sure that I go with the grain. I'm never going against it, leaving scratches. Just going with it, turn it a bit of an angle here. I'm still going with the grain. And there's bits like this where you just want to go right up to it and go like that, but you've got to kind of be patient and go with the grain. I got a sort of Maker's Mark logo made up, and I want to put it on the side of the hammer. Now I can either three hand this, I'm just petrified of getting it wrong. I'm not centered. Right, let that dry, and then got something else to put on it. So the other day we made up some beeswax polish with some essential oils. This is black spruce. And now I'm gonna put it on here. Cool, it is dry. Smells amazing.
It does, doesn't it? Makes that end grain come out beautifully.
It does,
look at
that.
It's so satisfying.
It is.
The smell.
I know. It's nice and powerful, isn't it?
Yeah, it's perfect. I think we put the perfect amount in.
You did.
I'd be wanting to rub this all over every bit of wood in my home. Cam was sanding this earlier outside the front of the van. I don't know if he actually recorded this bit, but he was doing it at an angle that looked very suspicious to people walking past. And I'm wondering if we're, there we go. Look at that, with the polish, it's practically erotica.
Is it drizzling?
A little bit of drizzle. Poppy loves the smell.
It does. I can't touch anything.
Do you want me to hold it?
How does that smell?
I don't know, you don't have to touch it. I think I love the colour change on the mahogany even more.
It's always a favourite part of the job.
Or actually getting to see it finished like this.
Yeah, getting to see what it's actually going to probably look like at the end.
It's really beautiful how you fit that edge on it.
Mm.
Do you do that by hand?
Yep. What's nice to work with this polish is that it doesn't matter if it goes on your hands.
Well, yeah, because it's basically moisturiser.
Yeah. So,
I guess that's a really good difference to...
Well, because with, like, if I was putting, like, osmos oil or something like that on, I wouldn't be able to do anything like this. Well. Job done.
Wait till the car goes past and say that again.
There we go. Job done. Thank you all for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it.
Try again, more serious.
So I hope you've enjoyed me watching it.
I hope you enjoyed me watching it.
Fuck you, Rachel. So I hope you've all enjoyed watching me make this beautiful mallet, if I say so myself.
It is stunning.
You can't talk in the background. You're sorry. Literally a
sorry.
So I hope you've all enjoyed watching me make this beautiful little mallet. I know I'm going to enjoy using it. Like and subscribe. Leave a comment if you've got any. Let me know how I did. And I'll see you on the next one.
What are you going to hit with it first?
You. Are you still filming?
Yeah.